Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. This is Exaltes.
This is Bad Wolf.
And what are we doing today?
We are watching StarCraft.
Outstanding.
It's pretty cool.
All right, so let's go ahead and introduce the players. In our bottom left position, we have Nom Lunatic. And in the top right as blue, we have Nom Seviol.
And Nom Lunatic is, I believe, a Masters Protoss. I'm not sure if he's placed this season, but he's a Masters Protoss, and Nom Seviol is either a Masters or a High Diamond about to be promoted to Masters. He tells me every night he's about to get promoted to Masters.
I was going to say, I thought he was Diamond. Last time I checked, he was. And I thought he played Protoss. I don't remember him playing Zerg.
He plays Random now, but he plays Zerg.
Really?
We've whined to each other about how much we hate playing Protoss as Zerg. So I have a feeling that might have something to do with his switch to Random. Just saying. He's really good, though. He will get Masters. He's not just saying that.
Yeah, I know we took a lot of his time away playing some Photon Cycles with him. We pretty much dragged all the Noms over there.
And there's nothing really going on right now. It actually looks like Nom Seviol might even be going for a fast expansion, which will make me rant, but in the minute of nothing happening, we can plug the best custom game ever, which of course is...
Photon Cycles.
If you like Tron, you like Photon Cycles.
Definitely. If you guys haven't had a chance to check it out, I think it's on page 4 if you go to All now.
Okay, so things are actually starting to happen. Nom Lunatic's looking pretty standard, just kind of...
Is he going to cannon rush him?
It's gate. I don't know, but Seviol just fast expanded, and no, Lunatic's just going with a standard gate opening. A lot of Protoss would actually instantly cannon rush a fast expand like this. Some people think it's so risky that they say it's bad. Other people fucking love it. I know Cats likes it a lot. There are a couple other Zerg players who I'm blanking on, but it's valid.
Right, well, what do you think it was up with that pylon? Did you think you didn't see it or something, or...?
Oh, I wasn't watching. Where was the pylon in the natural?
No, it was all the way up in the top right. It was right next to his mineral line.
He was just intimidating him then. This is actually a good time to talk about Lunatic. Lunatic's a really good Protoss, but he's known for being a little, let's just say unique.
Cheesy?
Cheesy, perhaps? Well, he's really good, and he actually, he'll do, like, these really strong builds and then expand, so he's not, like, don't get me wrong, I'm in no way shit-talking his skill. He actually crushed me, like, pretty mercilessly multiple times. But, yeah, he's very liable to build lots of units very quick, especially if he sees this fast expand from Seviol, I would think.
Yeah.
But we'll see what happens.
I think he's going to go for maybe, like, one base all-in, most likely.
Maybe. I would think there's a definite likelihood of lots of units. Because he has two gas already.
Right.
Which definitely lets us know, like, okay, there are two ways to respond to a really fast, greedy expand like this. Though actually, I take that back because Nom is on gas and getting speed and stuff like that. But still, he can either kind of push him with some units to make the Zerg have to not drone completely, or he can take a really quick base for himself, which he clearly isn't doing because he already
has
two.
That's why I was thinking he might go for one base all-in since he hasn't already put up that expansion.
Yeah, I mean, it is 25 food. We're in that range. I'm excited to see... Oh, there it is. Okay, we have a two-gate Stargate going down. Very cool. Ooh. See Seviol moving out with the first couple of scouting wings to see what's going on. Meanwhile, he's going back on gas. He's gotten 20 drones, getting a queen building. Everything looks on track to, like, a cool game. We'll see what he does when he sees that there's no expansion.
I think he's going to stop droning up for the most part. Should be going... I don't know. He should expect some sort of attack coming soon. Since he knows his opponent has the has expanded, you know.
So he sees right now that there's no expansion, losing a wing. And, alright, he scouts the Stargate. So, very cool. Now we'll see what he decides to do. It is interesting. He's building two spines, so I assume he's going to try to drone heavy behind that.
I would assume so. What would your response be as a Zerg seeing a starport go up and you've already expanded?
Against Lunatic, once I was done freaking out, I would ideally, I would want to have a quick third and defend it solely with queen positioning and, like, one cleverly placed spore at each base.
You would expand again?
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm kind of blanking against, like, a fast expand Stargate. No, I would, but I would try to drone up heavily and just hold with queens and spores. Which it looks like Nom wants to do. Yeah, I don't see. Yep, there's a third queen going down. He has a couple spines in case he pushes with like a bunch of units in a void.
Looks like he has four queens out.
I actually, the reason I blinked there is I faced a Forge Fast Expand into Stargate earlier, and it pissed me off. But I beat it.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to push out here with three Zealots and one Stalker. I think those Spine Crawlers right there are just going to shove that right back in, especially with those Queens. But we do have one Void Ray coming out.
I mean, we have two Queens right on the Void Ray, can handle that. Three Spines, more than enough for the units. I think Seb's fine. We see. Oh yeah,
the
hell
spine
yeah!
Crawler just tore up that Stalker. He needs to get that void. He just needs to pull back. Four queens, spine crawlers. He's not gonna have any chance of pushing in there right now.
Oh, absolutely. We got another spine going down. So we got four queens and four spines.
Oh, wow.
I think.
Yeah.
Well, Lunatic made the right call. He took an instant expansion. He's like, all right, I'm not getting in there.
Yeah, I realized that was gonna happen. Probably gonna just go ahead and get a whole bunch more probes. Looks like he has two guys. Yep.
Food's looking pretty even, the drones are looking pretty even, I mean, Seth has a three drone lead, so I mean, this might just sieg into a nice little mid-game. I'm really curious to see what Seville's gonna go after this opening. I feel like there are a lot of different little things he could do to basically punish how, like, late the defense is gonna be for his second base.
Right, and that was a really late expo. I mean, 9 minutes in, just not getting it up. It's not even actually up yet, so.
He could also just choose to take, like, mad expansions and drone like crazy. And then he could be scared of two base pushes. We'll see. We will see. He's already at 41 drones to 35 probes, so Seville's looking great. I'm not going to lie, I'm very prejudiced for the Zerg in ZVP, because I'm a bad Zerg. So.
Oh, you're not that bad. Still beat me. The day I beat you is when you can say, you know, you're a bad Zerg.
Word. I did lose to Zergling. It may have been after a significant amount of shots, but...
Well, yeah. So you were pretty hammered that night. I think I could have easily taken you that time.
Hey, while nothing's happening, though, by the way, awesome creep spread from Seville. Hell yeah. Zergling's another player of the greatest custom game ever. Which is?
Photon Cycles.
Hell yeah. Okay, back to the game. We see Lunatic with a tiny little army. This is the problem with doing a, like, 3-gate Stargate into an expand. Like, he doesn't have very much. But he's up at 42 probes now, so he can pop down a whole bunch of army fast if he just throws up more gates.
Looks like we've got a spire going down for Seville here.
Hell yeah.
I hate Mutalisk. That is, as playing Protoss, I cannot stand it.
Seville really likes his Mutalisks versus Protoss. This is actually the first thing we talked about, because I hate Mutalisks for Protoss as Zerg. They're good, but I think they're really risky. In this situation, though, I think they're fucking awesome. Oh,
looks like we've got a third going down for Seville down here.
Hell yeah.
No, I've learned that one thing as Protoss, you really have to know how to split those units if you got Mutalisks coming into your base. Like right now, all he needs to do is drag those Mutalisks around back, and it doesn't look like he has any cannons, nothing up.
Nope, and his arm is all... It's in a decent position to move into defense, but yeah, Seville can automatically get a couple of probes.
Yeah, he does have Blink, and it's looking like the Mutalisks are coming downfield, and they're going to run straight into his... Oh, come on, Lieutenant, move him forward!
Ah, move your army, dude! You're fine, dude. There's like, oh, actually, there's a decent amount of Muta. How many is that? 11 Muta for Sev. What I don't like about...
Right here, pulling them right around back and pick off some pylons, and here comes the split. Only three? Okay, five Stalkers to take care of this? I don't know about that one.
I mean, it's only 11 Muta. Like, if he loses even two Muta, then the trade's worth it. Like, a lot of Zerg players forget each Muta is 100 gas. But yeah, this is... Losing a lot more units than he had to.
So good for him. I don't know. How many Muta did he lose?
He's at 14 now. He's still making them. See, here's the thing. Like, he's on 3 base and 54 drones, so he can afford to kind of trade semi-evenly with the Stalkers, you know?
Right, and it looks like Lunatic only has about 5 or 6 Stalkers left.
Yeah, like, okay, what I normally hate about Muta versus Protoss is that I always feel like the Protoss can split up his units and just be fine with a good amount of Stalkers. But with Lunatic's opening, he can't really get that many units. So you see now he's going Archons for the splash, so he'll be fine. But yeah, I like the Muta versus the failed Stargate.
Failed Stargate, huh?
Screw
I don't know,
it.
I think maybe if you would have pushed out with two Void Rays and brought him around the back instead of, like, heading straight into the front defenses, he might have had more of a chance of doing something, at least picking up a few drones.
Yeah, if he'd, like, split up the attack a little bit, it could have.
Right.
I don't know, Seb's pretty solid, though, honestly, with that four queens, three spines, I feel like he could hold anything, like, as long as he sees it before he starts warping in. Seb will
like
just...
Quest trying to throw down a photon cannon right there, but
yep,
not
got
working.
Got the cancel, but he's getting shoot away.
Please bring one of those Archons up there. Oh, wait, he only has one. I thought he had more than one by now.
Nah, but this is great. I mean, he's holding him back while... Does he have 81 drones, or is my screen just too bright? Seville has 81 drones and three bases with a macro hatch building. He's pretty fine.
He's in a pretty good position right now. As long as he can keep Lunatic from expanding, I think he should definitely have this one. Especially with his realist running around, just picking off stuff.
Yeah, I kind of feel like when it's at this point where Zerg's already managed to get droned up and have a bunch of bases, the main thing Zerg's really only scared about is whatever two-base timing Lunatic's going to do. Like, I think it's actually kind of, not to criticize someone who's definitely better than me, but he should be chronoing upgrades right now for said timing. Like, if he doesn't make some focused timing to kill at least one base, there's no way he could come back.
Right. He needs to get that plus two going, at least minimum.
Yeah.
15 minutes in, only got one upgrade.
Especially because this patch happened, made all the upgrades cheaper.
Yeah, that too.
Tisk, tisk. That said, he only has 200 gas, so he is spending pretty well.
He missed two drones off the assimilator. Looks like they got picked off. He needs to replace those. Zero on this one down there.
So I got totally distracted because it was my first cast, but I was supposed to be talking about tech paths. But now I'm going to point out Sev is almost completing his Greater Spire, which is going to be like the death knell for Lunatic here. He's taking bases on the opposite sides, and he's getting up his Crackling and 1-1 upgrades. So, I mean, Lunatic's time is running out is pretty much what I'm saying.
Looks like we got some Broodlords coming in. Looks like Lunatic is actually going to try to make a push into there.
See, like, I like this push, but I feel like it's, like, a little late and not enough upgrades.
Right.
And he's only at 116 supply, and yeah, we'll see what happens. If he can just kill a base, he's cool.
Yeah, it looks like he should go up to the north side, but oh my goodness, there's so many lings.
Sev doing exactly what he should be doing. The lings are all on the north side, the meteor on the south. He's prepared to counterattack or have a super surround.
Yep, here comes
look at this. Broodlords on the right, Zerglings on the left, Muta on the south. This is the Zerg I would like to be playing a little bit better.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is going to be GG very soon. Oh my goodness, those Broodlords just ate through that Archon. And this is looking horrible.
See, Sev? So Seth doesn't even care, he's just A-moving his mutants. He knows that the Broodlords and Lings got this. Well, it was a valiant effort, but... Yeah,
no, he definitely should have gone for a better 2-base timing, or at least known that he wasn't going to be able to get up that 3 and work on getting a much larger army. I definitely think he could have done a lot better job of defending against those mutalists, too.
Yeah, I think my biggest thing I would say is the upgrades. I feel a Protoss with 2-2 is terrifying to a Mutaling Zerg, and if he had hit before Broodlords with 2-2 or something, which is totally feasible, I think that's and when I offer his Protoss, I'm not the greatest Protoss, but that's what I do against Muta, is I just chrono up to 2-2 and do mass gateway things, because that Protoss do mass gateway things.
Right, I definitely think this is going to be GG. There's no way he can get out of this one. He's only got maybe, 10 Stalkers if that? At most.
Absolutely.
Broodlords in his base, Lings all up in his mirror line, nothing. There's no way he can salvage.
We see 2-2 about to finish for the Lings. Not that they really need that much more help.
Not like they need any more help than they already have.
But well played by Seville. I really like see his creep spreads almost to the middle. Real nice.
Definitely. Also kept a lot of pressure on the Protoss player, not letting him think that he couldn't move out to get a third or anything like that, not allowing him to play any sort of macro game. And GG by Lunatic.
Oh yeah, GG Nom Sep. Nom Nom.
This one.